common questions that I've asked by my audience is how to store homemade dog food. My go-to way is with a vacuum sealer. Vacuum sealers can be found in many stores. Most big box stores have them. You can order them online, and you can get some that are very, very affordable on any budget. So that's my go-to. One, it's very simple. Two, it stores the food the longest. I make my dog food in bulk and I freeze it for long-term use, so I'm not in here cooking for my dogs a couple of times a week. I usually have like one weekend day a month where I just sort of stay in the kitchen and cook all day, and I make a bunch of different recipes, and I use a vacuum sealer to store my dog's meals. I will, in just a minute, I'll talk to you about how I portion and store, but a couple of other ways to do it. The other way that I do sometimes is in airtight containers. You want to make sure these are Pyrex containers that have the seal around them, so when you close them, they are sealed. This is especially important if you're going to be freezing your dog food, because you don't want it to get freezer burned, and it'll go bad much faster. So containers are great. You can buy these little like single serve containers if you have small dogs, the larger containers if you have multiple dogs or a large breed. The other way that you can do it is with Ziploc bags. Now, first of all, depending on whether you're storing it in the refrigerator or the freezer, if you're gonna be freezing it, you wanna buy the Ziploc bags that are specifically for the freezer. They have a stronger zipper, they secure better, the bags are thicker, and they prevent freezer burn longer. So you wanna buy those. I don't typically use Ziploc bags for two reasons. One, it's more wasteful, they're not reusable. You just throw them out when you're done, instead of like, you know, the vacuum seal bags are the same way. You have to throw those out when you're done as well. So, you know, these two are not the most eco-friendly options, but obviously the containers, you know, you can use over and over and over again. So that's one reason. And two, these ones are really messy. The vacuum sealer containers, you put the food in and it seals themselves. This one, you put the food in, sometimes it gets all over the place when you're putting the food in. If you get food on your hands and then you're trying to zip it, it gets everywhere. So I just prefer, that's kind of my last resort, but it can absolutely be done. Now, talking about storage time, if you're gonna refrigerate, most homemade dog food recipes are good in the refrigerator for 3 to 5 days. That's a kind of an average. In the freezer, the average is about 2 months. Some can be upwards to 3 months. So that's great if you're gonna make the recipes in bulk, and you can store any of these ways either in the refrigerator or the freezer. Just make sure however you store it, it's airtight. I portion my meals. So we have 4 dogs currently, two small, a medium, and a large. So what I will do is portion for each dog. You could also say, you know, you needed a cup for the large breed, a half a cup for the medium, and a quarter of a cup for each of my small breeds. So that would be 2 cups per meal, 2 meals a day. I need 4 cups of food. So I could use a large container like this and portion 4 cups, and that would be a day's worth if you wanted to do that. So I usually do that way. It's a lot easier when you're taking it out. I take out a container, let it thaw, and then pop it in the refrigerator. It's good in there for a few days. So I usually keep a few days at a time in the freezer and just sort of rotate like that. If you have any other questions about storing homemade dog food, feel free to send me an email. Thanks for watching this video guide.